बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। अस्सलामुअलैकुम। आई एम मोहम्मद ज़ीशान शाह एंड आई एम प्रेजेंटिंग ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ ग्रुप जे विद ऑल ऑफ माय ग्रुप मेंबर्स। इन दिस वीडियो लेक्चर वी विल डिस्कस हैमिल्टन प्रिंसिपल विद एग्जांपल्स। द कंटेंट्स ऑफ टुडे प्रेजेंटेशन इज here the topic I discuss is Hamilton principle introduction। In 1834 William Hamilton hypothesized that the particle follow a path that minimize the integral। From this postulate the equation of Lagrangian can be derived। I will draw an example of Hamilton principle, a particle which is moving from point A to a point B। There are many choices for the particle to move from A to B। There is a path, nearby path I represent, but the Hamilton says that the true path for the particle to move from A to B is the straight line। This is the concept of Hamilton principle, and Hamilton principle says that the Lagrangian, integration of Lagrangian, is stationary।
Assalamu alaikum, I am Hamza Naveed and I am presenting Lagrangian। Lagrangian mechanics is reformulation of classical mechanics introduced by the Italian French mathematician and astronomer Joseph Louis Lagrange। Lagrangian function, also called Lagrangian quantity that characterizes the state of physical system। In mechanics the Lagrangian function is just the kinetic energy, that is energy of motion, minus the potential energy, that is energy of position। Here is the equation of for conservative system of Lagrange equation। There is a point that why we use Lagrangian instead of Newton, because Newton approach requires that you find acceleration in all three directions, equate F is equal to ma, solve for the constraint forces and then eliminate these to reduce the problem to characteristic size। But Lagrangian approach enables us to immediately reduce the problem to the characteristic size। We only have to solve there for that many equation in the first place। What about the real system? Complexity increased by vectorial equations, constraints, no general procedure, but Lagrangian provides us avoiding some constraint, equation presenting in a standard form। So here is a picture that describe the difference between Newton and Lagrangian equation।
Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim, respected sir and dear fellows, assalamu alaikum। I am Muhammad Usman, here I am presenting generalized coordinate system। In this video we discuss what is a generalized coordinate system and why it is used in mathematics or calculus of variation। Now let us start। In mathematics we use different coordinate system to describe a position of a particle or system, for example rectangular coordinate system, cylindrical coordinate system or spherical coordinate system, etc. But in variational problems Cartesian coordinate system are not always best for us। In this situation we use generalized coordinate system। The generalized coordinate system is defined as the minimum number of independent coordinates or variables which is required to explain the state or location of the dynamical system। Generalized coordinates are denoted by q, generalized velocity is denoted by q dot and time by t।
Assalamu alaikum, I am Muhammad Nadir Abbas and I am presenting the topic, the example of Hamilton principle, which is simple pendulum। Here we define a simple pendulum of mass m with length l, and we see in the figure that the motion of pendulum is along mg sin theta. And since the angle theta, which is small, then we approximately equal to sin theta is equal to theta. And also, let a position of the mass m at time t, which is x of t and y of t, and the length l, which is equal to l square, is equal to x square plus y square, and we use the polar coordinates rather than the coordinates, which is x of t and y of t. And also we define the kinetic energy, which is equal to T is equal to 1 over 2 mv square. And in polar coordinates, which is equal to 1 over 2 ml square phi dot square of T. And also the potential energy is V is equal to mgh, and h is equal to L into 1 minus cos phi of T. And the gravity, where G is gravitational constant. And we define the Lagrangian on phi and phi dot, which is equal to T minus V. And now the Hamilton principle implies that the motion from a given initial angle phi of T naught to a fixed angle phi of T1, which is such that the functional J of phi, which is a stationary.
Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. I am Mr. Muhammad Munawwar, and I am presenting an example based on Kepler problem. What is Kepler problem? It is one of the most heavily studied problem in classical mechanics. We consider the simplest problem of single planet orbiting around the sun and ignore the rest of solar system. We suppose that sun is fixed at the origin. Then kinetic energy of the planet is given by T is equal to 1 over 2 m into x dot square plus y dot square, because kinetic energy is equal to 1 over 2 mv square. And after solving it, we will get that equation, where r and theta denote polar coordinates, m is the mass of planet. We can deduce the potential energy function V from gravitational law of attraction. What is gravitational law of attraction? We know that gravitational force is directly proportional to the product of masses and is inversely proportional to the square of the distance between them. And when we remove the proportionality, we get F is equal to minus G mm over R square. And here G is the universal gravitational constant, small m is the mass of planet, capital M is the mass of sun, and R is the distance between them, which is gravitational force. And potential energy function F is equal to minus partial V over partial R, and we will integrate it with respect to R. So we will get V of R is equal to minus G mm over R. This is potential energy. And now Lagrangian is equal to, we know that Lagrangian is equal to kinetic energy plus potential energy. So Lagrangian is equal to 1 over 2 m r dot square plus r square theta dot square, which is kinetic energy, plus g m m over r, that is potential energy. Now Hamilton principle implies that the motion of planet from an initial observation to a final observation is such that are given, and which is stationary. Thank you.
Thank you very much for watching our video.
Hello.